Let us discuss first exercise problems on the direct and inverse proportions. The first question, following are the car parking charges near a railway station up to 4 hours 60 rupees, 8 hours 100 rupees, 12 hours 140 rupees, 24 hours 180 rupees. Check if the parking charges are in direct proportion to the parking time. What is the relation of the direct proportion? The direct proportion relation is if X and Y variables are any related of the objects, this is nothing but car parking with the cost, that is the charges. Here X1, Y1, some particular time, the charge is Y1 rupees, particular time X2, the charge is Y2 rupees, particular time X3, the charge is Y3 rupees. In the direct proportion, the relation becomes X1 by Y1 is equal to X2 by Y2 equal to X3 by Y3. That is nothing but X1, Y2 equal to X2, Y1. Both values are equal. So those two are in directly proportional, if whatever the things. Okay. Here, first we can write the given data in the tabular form. The first one is parking hours and charge, parking charge, okay, charges, okay, 4 hours, how much cost? 60 rupees, 8 hours, 100 rupees, 12 hours, 140 rupees, 24 hours, 180 rupees, okay, just we can check out. Is it in direct proportion or not? Here, 4 by 60 is equal to 8 by 100. Then cross multiply, 4 into 100 equal to 8 into 60. Okay, from this 400 is equal to 480. 8 6 are 48 into, that is nothing but 8 into 60 is 480. These two are not equal. Okay. And one more thing, 8 hours by 100 rupees equal to 12 hours by 140 rupees. Here 10, 10 cancel. 8 into 14 equal to 12 into 10. That is 8 4s are 32. 112 rupees equal to 120. So this, the relations, the values are not equal. So it is not in direct proportion. Not in direct proportions. If we can take 4 by 60 equal to 8 by 100, equal to 12 by 140 equal to 24 by 180 means in all the zeros are get cancelled. 2 2s are 2 3s are, 4 2s are 4 5s are. Here 2 6s are 2 7s are. The relation is not in proportion, not in the same ratio. So it is not in the direct proportion. We can take any relation, either x1 y1 equal to x2 y2, or equating any two relations if the two values are equal. So it is in direct proportion, otherwise it is not in direct proportion. Okay, the next problem, the second problem, a mixture of paint is prepared by mixing one part of red pigments with 8 parts of base. That is one part of red pigment with 8 parts of base. In the following table, find the parts of base that need to be added. First, the tabular form is parts of red pigment and parts of base. Here, the parts of red pigment 1, the parts of base is 8. In the second column, it is nothing but it convert into 4 means multiply with 4, then 8 is also multiply with 4. So 4 ones are 4, 8 fours are 32. So this becomes 32. Next, the base is multiplied with 7. The red pigment is multiplied. Red pigment is multiplied with 7. Base is also multiplied with 7. Why? Because the parts, 8 parts are more of the base. So 8 sevens are 56, 1 seven is 7. So it is the 56. Okay. Next, one red pigment part is multiplied with 12, then 12 parts of red pigment means 8 is multiplied with 12, then 12 times of the 8 parts of the base, that is 12 8s are 96. In the same way, one part of the red pigment is multiplied with 20 means the base is also multiplied with 20. 120 is a 20, 820 is a 160. So the gaps are filled with 96 and 160. So the ratio is in all same. 4 ones are 4 eights are, 7 ones are 7 eights are, 12 ones are 12 eights are, 20 ones are 20 eights are. So this is in the directly proportional. The mixing of the color is mixed with the same base. It is the answer. In question 2, above question, one part of red pigment requires 75 ml of base. That is nothing but red pigment part of red pigment, and it requires the base. Base. How much base? One part of red pigment is requires the 75 ml base. How much red pigment should we mix with 1800 ml of base? Here, the relation of the red pigment with the base they have given. In the directly proportional, mix with means we use the directly proportion, that is direct proportion. The relation of the direct proportion means if the two objects, that is X, Y, or the two objects, we can take the X1 parts with the Y1 base and X2 parts with the Y2 base. From this, we take that relation, then X1, Y2 should be equal to X2, Y1, or we can take the relation of the direct proportion, let it be X1, Y1, it is X2, Y2. So we can write in that relation, that is 1 by 75 ml is equal to, we don't know the second part, that is the red pigment, parts of the red pigment, but we know the base, that is 1800 ml. ml, ml get cancelled. So the X is equal to 1 into 1800 ml by 75. Okay. 1800 is divided with 75. 75 twos are 150. Then it's 0. 8 minus 5 is 3. Take 0. 75 fours are 300. Okay. 5 fours are 22. 7 fours are 28. 300. So 75 ones are 75, 24s are. Therefore, 24 parts of red pigment mix with 1800 ml base. It is the answer. Fourth problem. A machine in soft drink factory fills 840 bottles in 6 hours. Here we can take the construct the tabular form, that is number of bottles, number of hours. Okay, taking time. Here 840 bottles can fill in 6 hours. And how many bottles, question mark, will it fill in 5 hours? So this is also, the machine is always in directly proportional. In 1 hour, it fills how much number of bottles, then 2 hours, the double, 3 hours, three times, 4 hours, four times. In that way, they have given the relation in the direct proportion. The machine is working in the direct proportion. So we can take the relation is x1 by y1 equal to x2 by y2. Here, the first one is x1, y1, it is x2, y2. Okay. And we can substitute in the place of x1, 840, y1 is 6 hours equal to x2, we don't know, we should find out that one. And y2 is the 5 hours. And cross multiply, x2 equal to 840 into 5 by 6. 6 ones are 6, 6 fours are 24, 0. It is equal to 500, 5 fours are 22, 5 ones are 5 plus 2, 7. So in 5 hours, it fills in 5 hours, machine fill the 700 bottles. It is the answer. The fifth question, a photograph of bacteria enlarged 50,000 times attains the length of 5 centimeters, as shown in the diagram. This is the enlarged times is the 50,000. The length is, if we enlarged 50,000 times, then that is the 5 centimeters. Okay. No, only one time. That is nothing but the 50,000 times. It is nothing but we can find out the actual length. What is the actual length means? No enlarging. That is the one time equal to how much? Okay. That is the actual length. And if the photograph is enlarged 20,000 times, then what is the length of that bacteria? Okay. Actually, the bacteria is the microorganisms. And if we can enlarge 50,000 times, then we can see in the 5 centimeter length of the bacteria. So here it is also, the enlarging is also directly proportional relation. Okay. The directly proportional relation is x1 by x, y1 is equal to x2 by y2. Here, we can take 50,000 by 5 centimeter equal to 1 by how much? That is y2. So, y2 equal to 5 by 5 centimeter by 50,000 times. That is equal to 5 ones are 5, 10,000. 10,000 means 1 by 10 power 4. That is equal to 10 to the power of minus 4. Okay. The actual length is how much actual length of bacteria equal to 10 power minus 4 centimeter. And we can take the second one. That is the 20,000, the 50,000 times. It is the first case. In the second case, we can take the same relation. The 50,000 times can see in the 5 centimeter. So for the 20,000 times, what is the relation or what is the length? So y is equal to 20,000 into 5 centimeter by 50,000 times. 4 zeros cancel, 5 ones are 2, that is the 2 centimeter. So it is in 20,000 times, then the length of the bacteria is, the length of the bacteria we can see in 2 centimeter when we enlarge 20,000 times. Okay, this is the answer.